Hello and welcome to another video from Dan's Tutorials. In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at Safari profiles on the iPhone. This was introduced in iOS 17. Now, before we get started, if you like what you see here, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, with that out of the way, let's take a look at Safari profiles. Now, the first thing is you may want to know what Safari profiles are. Well, with Safari profiles, what you can do is you can create different profiles based on what you are doing. And each profile is going to have their own favorite bookmarks. They're also going to keep their own browsing history. So it's going to keep the history separated from each profile. Also, each profile can have its own set of extensions. And each profile keeps its own separate cookies and browsing data. So it's almost like Safari is being split up into different browsers. So that's what Safari profiles are. The next thing you may want to know is, why do we want to use Safari profiles? What are some case scenarios where you would use this? Well, the first thing is you may want to create a profile for work and personal, with each having their own history, each having their own cookies, each having their own cache, each having their own favorite bookmarks, and their own start page. Or what you may want to do is create a profile for your spouse or partner, giving them their own favorite bookmarks and their own history. So when they use your phone, they're going to have their own favorite bookmarks, their own history. You may want to create a guest profile for one-time or temporary users. This gives them a fresh, clean browsing experience while keeping your history separate from that. And then also you can create a troubleshooting profile for when you're having an issue with a site. Switch over to that troubleshooting profile. See if you still have an issue with that site. If you do, that means that there may be a problem with the site and how it works on the iPhone. But if you don't have an issue with it on that separate profile, what you may need to do is just go and delete the history from that profile that you're having an issue with. That means that there might be a caching problem or something like that. So you can also use profiles to help troubleshoot. So those are some reasons why you may want to use Safari profiles. Now, before we get started with creating profiles, I thought the next thing that we could do is we could just take a look at a few profiles and how we get around, so you can get an idea of what they are. Then what I'll do is I'll show you how we actually create them. So let's go and take a look at a few Safari profiles, just demo a few Safari profiles. So the first thing that we need to do is we need to go over to my iPhone and take a look at Safari profiles, or take a look at Safari. Now, the first thing that we need to do is we just need to open up Safari. Everything is within Safari. We manage this within the settings, which I'll show you later on. But first, let's just take a look at profiles. So I'm just going to open up Safari here. And what I'm looking at right now is my personal profile. So this shows my personal favorites here, as well as items that are shared with me. And I can see my privacy report. It also has an orange background. And you're going to see that it has just a little icon there indicating that this is my personal profile. Now, let's say that I wanted to work. So I want to go to my work profile. To do that, all we have to do is just tap on the two little squares here, tap on it, and then you're going to see the profiles down here at the very bottom. When I tap on that, I'm able to switch to a different profile. So let's just go over to work, and you're going to see that this color here is going to change as well as my favorites. So I just go over here to personal, and we're going to go to work. And now we can see that it says work up here, it is blue, and I have the little graduation cap for Dan's Tutorials. I also have different favorites there. And if I were to scroll up, I could further customize this start page. Let's go over to shopping. I have a shopping profile. So now again, I just tap on this. And then we go to profile and I go to shopping. And we can see it's a different color. We have a different icon here indicating that it is for shopping. And it has my favorite shopping bookmarks there. And then I also have another profile for guest. So I tap on this, we go to guest. And now if I were to hand my phone to someone, They would not be able to see my favorite bookmarks or my work bookmarks or anything like that. It also doesn't have anything that is shared with me. It just has a privacy report, and I can easily see what profile I'm in because it's a different color here. So that's basically how Safari profiles work. Pretty simple. We just tap on the little two squares here, and then we can select our profile right down there. Once we switch that profile, the bookmarks are going to change, the color is going to change, the start page is going to change, as well as any extensions that I have enabled may change. All right, so now that we know what these profiles are, let's take a look at how we can create and manage these profiles. What I'm going to do is just go and remove all those profiles, and we're just going to start from scratch. So you're going to see how this all works, and it's really pretty simple how it all works. So let's go back over to my iPhone and see where we go and set these up. So first thing that we need to do is we need to go to our home screen, and we need to go to settings here. Under settings, what we need to do is swipe up until we find Safari. So I have Safari here. Let's go ahead and change that color so it's you can see it a little bit better. So I have Safari here, and we tap on that, and we have all of our different Safari settings. Now when I swipe up here, you're going to see that I have profiles here. This is where I go and manage them. What I'm going to do is just go and remove all of these, and we're just going to start from scratch. So to remove them, all I have to do is just tap on the profile, and you can see that I can delete that profile. So I just hit delete, and it goes and deletes it. So let's just go ahead and do that with these other two here, shopping and work. I can't delete the first profile. Once I remove the other two profiles here, what it will do is it'll also remove this one. But if you're going to notice that when I tap on personal, I cannot delete that one. We have to have at least one profile. If you don't use profiles at all, there's still going to be one profile, the default profile. All we're doing is just adding more. So let's just go ahead and delete those other two. So I tap on it, tap on delete, and tap on shopping, tap on delete. All right, so now this is how it is set up by default. So if you've never used profiles before, this is what your iPhone is going to look like when you're in Safari settings. Also, when I go back to Safari, you're going to see that when I go down to the two tabs here, I do not have my profiles here. So I can't switch any profiles because it just has one profile by default. So now what we need to do is we need to go back over to those settings and we tap on new profile. So I'm just going to tap on it. And let's just call this one work. So I tap on the name and I go work. I just go and tap on the icon I want to use. I tap on the color. Typically, I use blue for my work color. And then from here, I can set my favorites. I have a bookmark folder that is called work. So we can see that it is selected here. I can go and select a different folder if I wanted to. I just tap on this and I can go and select a different folder. But we're just going to go with work favorites here. It's just a folder within my bookmarks. And then I can set what I want new tabs to open up to. And they're just going to open up to the start page. So that's all there is to it. I tap on done, and we just created our first profile. So if I go back over to Safari, you're going to see that when I tap on this, I have the option to switch profiles. And I'm just going to have my two profiles there. So let's just go quickly add a couple more. We're going to add shopping and guest. So tap on done. We go back over to new profile. We're going to call this one shopping. And let's just go with purple, and we're going to go with the shopping bag and the favorites. Again, I have a bookmarks folder called shopping, which has some of my favorite websites. Could be Amazon, Etsy, eBay, things like that. So now I tap on done, and it's done. We're going to create one more. Let's just call this one guest. New profile, go guest. And with this one, we're going to go with green, and the favorites again is guest. Chooses that by default, but I could tap on that to change it if I wanted to. And what we need to do is choose a different icon here. We're going to go with this one here. So now I have my guest profile. So those are now my four profiles here. And when I go back over to Safari, you're going to see that I'm able to switch between those different profiles. Now, in addition to that, what we're also able to do is modify the extensions. We can install extensions with Safari on the iPhone. So how do we do that? Well, basically what we need to do is go back over to our settings, Safari settings. And when we tap on any one of these, actually what we need to do is tap on any one of these underneath our default profile. The extensions for personal here are going to be the default extensions. I'll explain that shortly. So let's just tap on work here. And you're going to see that now that it has been created, what I'm able to do is manage those extensions. So I tap on this and I can set which extensions I want to use. So if I go back over to shopping, manage extensions, I tap on these two here and now it'll use those extensions. I also don't want any ad blocks. I'm shopping, so maybe I want to see the ads. But when I go back over to work, I don't want to see those ads. So when I go to work here, manage extensions, I might turn these all on. And I'm going to leave these turned off. So now when I go into my work profile, ad block is going to be on, but the shopping extensions are going to be turned off. Now, there's one catch to this with the extensions. If we go over here to personal, you're going to see that I cannot manage those extensions. Why is that? Remember I said that the first one is the default profile? So in order to manage the default profile, what we need to do is we just need to go to our extensions within our Safari settings here. So I swipe up until I find my extensions. There they are. When I tap on these, this is going to manage all the extensions for the personal profile, for my default profile. But for all of the other profiles, what I am able to do is just go and tap on the profile here, and I can go and manage those extensions. Now, the last thing I want to show you is how you can modify your start page for each profile. To do that, what we need to do is we need to go back into Safari. And then from here, we just go and select our profile. So in this case here, I'm going to go to my personal profile here. I tap on the page, and then I swipe up. We tap on edit. And then from here, I'm able to customize that start page. I can turn anything on and off here. I can even change the background. And this will only affect the personal profile. If I want to change another one, so let's just go over here to work, you're going to see that it is blue. And when I tap on edit here, I can go and change all of these settings, and it's only going to affect that profile. So let's just go and change the background. It only affects that profile. So I don't have anything enabled here, but when we go back over to personal, you're going to see that it has everything enabled and it is gray. So we just have to go down to the bottom for each profile that we create and tap on edit, and then we can go and edit that start page. So that's all there is to creating these profiles. A little bit of work, but it's pretty simple to go and set them up. And then once you have them set up, the next thing that you need to do is just need to switch between these profiles. So let's cover that. You saw that in the beginning, but let's just take another quick look at that. To switch between your different profiles, all you need to do is just tap on the two squares here. And when you tap on that, you're going to see down at the bottom here which profile you're in. It's going to use that icon. You just tap on that. And then from here, you can switch to whatever profile you want. So it is about two or three steps, but still pretty simple. Go to work, and now I'm at work. Tap on it. Go to guest. Now I'm in guest. Also, each profile is going to have their own set of tabs as well. So if you have five tabs open in one profile and two tabs open in another, when you switch between those different profiles, it'll remember that because all of your history is going to be stick with that particular profile. So that's basically how profiles work on the iPhone. Now, I do have some key points that I want to point out. The first one is, of course, that each profile has their own browsing history, cookies, and cache, as well as their own extensions enabled and their own favorite bookmarks. Each profile does have access to all of your passwords. So your passwords are not specific to particular profiles. They're shared among all of your different profiles. In addition to that, all of your bookmarks are accessible from each profile. So it doesn't hide all of your bookmarks. All you are doing is you're just highlighting which bookmarks folder you're going to be using as your favorites. So you could share or use the same favorite bookmarks for all of your profiles, or you could use a different folder for each one of your profiles, which I showed you earlier. But all of the bookmarks are going to be accessible from all of your profiles. So don't think of it as someone is not going to be able to get at all of your bookmarks. They are going to be able to get at all of your bookmarks. All it is doing is just setting what your favorite bookmarks are by default. And then the last thing I do want to mention is that your profiles are automatically synced across all your different Apple devices. So this comes in handy where you could set up a profile on your iPhone and then use those same profiles on your Mac or iPad if you wanted to as well. So your profiles do sync among all of your different devices. So that is how profiles work on the iPhone. Basically, as I mentioned, it's like having separate browsers all within Safari. This could be great for creating a work or personal profile, or maybe you want to create one for your spouse or partner, or even create one for guests, or as I mentioned, troubleshooting. Switch to that troubleshooting profile when you have an issue with a particular website. That'll help you determine if it's something with your history or cache or anything like that. So that is how profiles work on the iPhone. Now, if you like what you see here, you may want to take a look at my website. I do have, as of this recording, over 400 videos on YouTube, but I have over 2,100 videos on my website, dancetutorials.com. It is a membership-based website, and it is a way that you could help support my efforts in creating these videos. When you become a member of my site, you get all of my ads, or all of my videos ad-free. You don't get any ads. You get the videos ad-free. You get access to an AI assistant that I modeled after an Apple Genius. You also get access to webinars that I host on a regular basis. I will usually have two or three webinars or classes that I host online through Zoom, and you get access to all of those classes for free or with your membership. Not free, but with your membership. And then the last thing is you're helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. I enjoy what I do here, and I hope that I'm able to help you. And if I am, like I said, what you can do is you can help support my efforts by becoming a member. And also, you are supporting a small business. So that's how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. I hope you liked the video. Check out dancetutorials.com for more.